masochist, sucker for punishment, I don't know. But if I thought that the record store was rough, boy, oh boy, this was a journey into the at least the fourth level of hell. Here you're looking at a 1/12 scale comic book store. It was a task. It took me about probably 3.5 to another 4 months to build this thing. I learned to take some shortcuts on this one. I learned, you know, you were getting... I did make a lot of this stuff from scratch, but I also, you know, cheated a little bit. At times I would buy dollhouse accessories, but that stuff got expensive. So again, I just started building the furniture again out of polystyrene, using contact cement, foam board, glue guns, you know, popsicle sticks, the same thing that I always use. You'll see here too that some of my cheats, you know, I use HeroClix. I use little miniature dollar bin toys. Accessories that you would find with all sorts of action figures. The boxes, of course, and, you know, they were all done by myself. You know, you're going to see, too, that there's... I noticed when I looked at it through the video, and there's a lot of imperfections. You see that little blue underneath the Predator there. That stuff's going to be cleaned up, but, you know, in the smaller scale, you really don't see all that glue gun webbing. The camera seems to be kind of unforgiving. I'll get to that. I'll clean that up. But I thought it'd be a laugh just to post this now. I also wanted to add not only you know, just a comic book store. I also wanted to have a role-playing game section. I was a Gary Gygax kid growing up and loved Advanced Dungeons & Dragons. So I had to have that in there. And you know, it's essential. This project that I'm doing here right now, apart from just like a tribute to a lot of stores that are disappearing, it's also something that I'm going to be using on a podcast series that I work on with some friends of mine called Cold Beer and Comics. And it's actually going to be the home base for us. So I think it'll be a laugh. What you're looking at, we're coming upon here now, in all its imperfections, and not, it's really not cleaned up again, I apologize, is, you know, the six-man X-Men arcade. Those of you in the know how I did this, but again, foam board, stickers, and bobby pins for the joysticks. And yeah, that's an iPhone in the background there. And someone played through, bless their soul, to the arcade. So there's the outside look of it. There's lights and various other things there, but I'm not going to keep rambling on here. And if you have any questions or something, just drop me a line. If you like it, fantastic. But yeah, I get it. You don't get the time back, so save yourself that heckle. All right. I love you.